y'all want to hang out and wrap some Christmas presents with me. Look, don't judge me. This is terrible. But I'm going to just tell you, I don't care. I don't. I am wrapping Christmas presents, and I just thought, you know, I'm going to go hang out with my friends. And I got on YouTube, and I was checking the comments because I posted a little thing, a little short thing yesterday about Jackson. He started preaching. He said a couple weeks ago he stood up in church, and he said that he had been called to preach, and it was, me and James, we didn't even know. We were like, what did he just say? And the preacher said, did you all know about that? And I was like, no. But Jax, he is a very quiet person, and I know that the Lord had been dealing with him for a while, and he surrendered, and I just pray. He's 12 years old. But don't you dare judge him. You pray for him, and you pray that the Lord will carry him through, because I know that there is a real enemy, and he is going to attack. And so, instead of saying mean and ugly things, I feel like we need to say, you know what? If the Lord has called you, he will equip you. And that's exactly what I told him. I said, don't you worry about people running your mouth saying you're too young. Jesus was 12 in the temple. So, anyways, let's just hang out and wrap some Christmas presents together. I can't remember where we left off. It's been a while, ain't it? I have just been busy. The boys, Jax is 12, Finn is, that's the Winnie dog. Finn is 10. No, he's not. I lied. He's going to be 10. Buck, shut your mouth. Buck, no. Oh my gosh, what am I trying to say? Finn is going to be 10 on December the 8th. So we are going to celebrate his birthday this coming weekend. I told him he could bring one friend and we would go do something fun. So that's what we're going to plan on doing. Hang on just a second. I had to run and get my wrapping paper. I bought it at the Dollar Tree this morning. Y'all know I'm cheap. Let me show it to you. These are cute. I got gingerbread. I got some trucks, and this is just really fun, little elves riding a motorcycle or whatever. And then I don't even need all these, a nutcracker, and then this has a sweet little weenie dog on it. I have become obsessed with weenie dogs. I know that's insane. But, don't judge me in the back. I know it looks terrible, but I don't have time to fool with it. It's 1 o'clock here, and I've got to get my stuff done before I go and get the boys at 3 o'clock. And then we have a banquet. We have all kinds of stuff to do. But, ever since, look at this. I can do both. Candy canes, too. That's pretty, ain't it? We'll go down to the Dollar Tree and get it. I think I paid $1.25 because they went up in prices. Let's see here. You saw that, didn't you? Jackson, you need to mind your own business. I know he's going to be watching. That's why I'm saying that. But you know what, y'all? Holidays are sometimes really hard on us because sometimes some of our loved ones or people that we love so much have passed away. And we get lonely. I know, sometimes you grieve people who are still alive because things are just not the same. I know I do that. I do. And it's awful. So I'm right there with you. So, let's just hang out today. I can't promise you when I'll be back, but at least we're together today, right? I think it was Miss Lisa who commented on my... Sorry. I think it was Lisa who commented on my my short yesterday, because I wanted you guys to see and hear Jax preaching, because you would just... You would be so fired up. As my preachers say, you would be ready to kick down hell's door with a water pistol and tell everybody about Jesus or something like that. I don't know what he says exactly. But you will just be so fired up. So when you get just a little bit, go back and watch my short. And in the comments, I'll left the link so you can watch him preach. If you don't have a lot of time, just know that he's on, he's around 31 minutes, I think, and just listen to him, and pray for him, too, because, you know, I was mean as a snake. My kids are sweet. Oh, how that happened. Probably because their daddy was always nice. He always got, like, most likely to succeed. Most, best all around. You know what I got? Most unique 2006. You know? I mean, they wasn't wrong, were they? That's funny now. What else is new? Well, I got a new job. Not by choice. It's a sad story. But... It's a sad story, and I can't tell you a whole lot, because I'm just not allowed, but, things happened, and me and another nurse got laid off. I'll just put it that way, and it really stuck. It came by total surprise, and I was like, what? Because I planned on retiring at the Wings funeral because I loved it. And we were family. We were just the most perfect team and the most perfect nurses, I think, because we really love our patients. Okay, we have boundaries. Don't get it twisted. But we just care so deeply about our patients, and we all worked well together, and we all used our brains to try and get people better, and then somebody came in and ruined it. That's all I'm going to say. But it's okay. I did get a new job. I'm working. I'm doing some home health, some one-on-one patient care, and I'm having so much fun, and I'm meeting so many people. One person, they call me Mrs. Cornbread, and because of how I talk. And they said that I was just a little extra crispy. So I don't know what that means, but I'll take it. You have to help me remember. That was to Jax. I don't think I told you that, but you have to help me. Let's see. So I guess I've been working there a couple months now. And it's okay. It'll be fine. I like it, but, you know, I miss my friends. I had some wonderful friends, and I'm making new friends, so it's good, but it's hard to start over sometimes, but the Lord is faithful, and I'm thankful that I still am very flexible with my schedule, so I can work this day or I can work that day. So basically my life revolves around the boys and their schedule. I'm their chauffeur. I take them to A to B. I go and get them from B to A. We come home. Praise God, James is cooking because he's a really good cook. I can't cook. I mean, I can, but it's not as good as his. Isn't that embarrassing? speaking of which, my mamaw, you know, mamaw, Grammy Ludell, I went to see her, and she got me a crock pot, and she wrote down all of her favorite recipes. So I'll have to share those with you. They are potato soup, which you have to make that because it is the most delicious thing in the whole entire universe. Potato soup. She says you need 4 cans of diced potatoes, 4 cans of Campbell potatoes soup, 1/2 pint of whipping cream. Listen. 1 quart of 1/2 and 1/2. 1/2 pint of whipping. I don't know what I just said. I don't even know what I wrote down. She's going to spank me to death. Let me just talk to her, and then I'll let you guys know. But listen, her hot dog chili is to die for. She puts this in the crock pot. 1 pound of ground beef, raw. 1 can of Campbell tomato soup. 1 tablespoon of chili powder. And 1 chopped onion. And it is so good. We had it on Sunday. I just put it in the crock pot that morning. Fired up some weenies after church. Ate them. Went back to church, Jackson preached, came home, had me another one. See, it was good. Now I gotta decide what I'm doing. I've decided. But I have to be very sneaky. Have to make sure, because I don't know when to say this. This is very special. When do you guys start buying Christmas presents? Because I try to start early. I don't like waiting to the last minute to do it because it stresses me out. It stresses me out, and when I get stressed out, James gets stressed out, and then I start freaking out, and he never freaks out. He's got the patience of Job. I don't. Okay, look. I have to make sure. Okay. I think we're good. So, what are some things that your babies... Don't you hate it when you lose everything in your wrapping presents? What are some of the things that your babies are asking for Christmas? Me and James are not buying for each other. We are taking a trip after Christmas. I don't know if you know this, but he works at FedEx. And this time of year is absolutely awful. And he works so hard and all the time, and it breaks my heart. And we like to go away, just me and him, and do nothing. I take multiple naps. I go to the Goodwills and the thrift stores, and I do all those things. Going to be so loud. So I am really just looking forward. Oh no, I missed it. I'm really looking forward to our trip. I think that'll be so fun. And I know that by the time Christmas gets here, he is really, really, really going to need that trip. So, anyways. Alright, guys. I feel I'm scattered brain and I'm just talking to myself. I'm going to press pause on that for a second. And I just want to tell you that I love you, and I'm sorry that I haven't been here. I'm just a mom. And I'm trying to take care of my boys and keep my head above water. And that's it. But I do want him to know that I love him. And not only do I love you, but the Lord loves you more than anything in this whole entire world. And don't forget, if you have air in your lungs, then the Lord has purpose for you. So you're going to have to get up. And if you're in the pit, you're going to just have to get out of that pit. And you're going to have to keep going. That's just all there is to it. You don't ever give up. And I love you. And I hope to see you one day. So, bye.